Hello! Wow! I cannot believe how many of you responded to my question, what is this move called? I had over 48 comments and 13 different answers as to what this movement is called. So I'm just going to run through them super quick because I love me a bit of data. Top of the naming with 18 was the TAK, T-A-K, or TAK, T-A-Q. So that was super popular. Then we had number 4 was alternating hip lift drop. I really like hip lift drop because it's descriptive of exactly what it is. The hip is lifting and dropping on the other side and alternating at the same time. So that was a good one. Hips going down. We had hip hits was number 3. So that came in at number 3. That is the name that I learned this movement as. So I kind of had to stop myself calling it that when I recorded the first video because I just wanted to be open and see what everyone thought. And then the next, there was another one that had 5, sorry, that came in 5, and that was Chonks. I have heard the name Chonks knocking around the scene. I don't know where it originated, I don't know where it came from. I have heard it. I know it's popular with a lot of people, but I probably am leaning towards TAK. The other names that we had were, what did we have? Soraya Zaki hips, side to sides, hip drops, only got 1. So hip drops, that was interesting. Hip snaps, another good one. Seesaw hip accents, I've not heard of that before. And I really like that one as well, because it really gives that idea of what's happening there. Glute singles. Now this one was really interesting to me because I do use my glutes with this movement, particularly when I take the movement to the side, I get in there with the glute. So only one person said that, so that was really interesting. And I've missed out, which one have I missed out? I've missed out piston hips, which had 3 people naming it as that. And I totally get where that comes from. It's quite strong. It's quite like pistons driving up and down. So again, another really descriptive one. So what am I going to call it going forward for the new year with my new students? Because I want to set them up on a journey where they can go to any belly dance class, any workshop, any festival, and join in and kind of know what's going on, because I got very confused by the terminology when I first started dancing. So I reckon I'm gonna go with hip tack because that seems to be the most common language used. I personally like hip tack because it's kind of like, that seems to be where I catch the move in the music. Everyone's different, but I like to catch that tack with the hip, tack, 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 tack. It seems to be on the up as the hip comes up and where you get that snap or that hitting or that piston kind of feeling. So I think we're all kind of coming at it from the same place and we're all capturing the same point in the music. And that's really what's difficult about the language for the dance, is that we're using the language to catch something that you express through your hands when you're playing the music and through your body when you're doing the dance. So You kind of can't really describe it. It kind of just is what it is. But yeah, I'm going to go with tack, and I'm going to go with intack for when I'm dancing in this position, and I'm going to go with an out tack when I'm taking it out to the side. There was a lot of talk about sliding in my comments, but I think that's a separate move, so I'll come back to that one another time. But I like the idea of taking the hip out and using the glute there to get the tack. And then you've got to do another one here, equal and opposite, tack here, changing the weight, and back in, you've got the tack here. So I've got out, in, out, in. So Yeah, so I think that really kind of wraps up everything I want to do with the hip tack. Thank you so much for commenting. It's been really, really helpful. I'm really excited to go and teach tomorrow, and looking forward to seeing some of you soon. Bye!